there's a Saltford Tunnel Bay, and you're allowed to enter the tunnel going northwards on the hour for 20 minutes past the hour between 12 and 4. Because it's one way, and there's a kink in the middle. Saltersford Tunnel. No, we've been passed some instructions. We're allowed to enter on the hour until 20 minutes past the hour. So obviously it's controlled like that. Reopened in April 1984 after repair work. Of course, a breeze blowing through here, and there's kinks in it too. It's not dead straight. Well, we're coming to the end of that now, and it was very weird going along in pitch black. And you do literally go around like a bend, and all of a sudden the tunnel entrance appears. So it's got a very definite bend in it. And another thing with this one is the wind's blowing through here. It's freezing cold. And it narrows right back down again just as you get into the entrance exit. There's a bit of canal and river trust activity going on here with several of their working boats. Some of the shuttering they're doing, strengthening the banks. So, still on the Trent Mersey Canal, having just done the Anderton boat lift. We're moored at Willow Green, which is, I don't know, 2 or 3 miles to Preston Brook. Now, Preston Brook's got a tunnel that we've got to go through. Don't like tunnels very much. I've had one or two incidences. Spatial skills perhaps not up to it. Anyway, and then we're going to turn onto the Bridgewater Canal and head off in the general direction of Manchester. So let's see what the day brings. Well, it's the first little narrow point of the day. A few boats moored here on a right hand curve. Well, it's not cold, but there is a breeze. It's making my eyes water. So after we've gone under this pipe bridge that goes into a left-hand bend, there is a boat moored actually on that bend, so hopefully there's not another boat coming in the other direction. So Canal and River Trust have done some extensive bank improvements there. And it looks like it's all clear. That's good. There's another little narrow point on a bend. I haven't actually seen any boats at all this morning. Bridge 208. It's quite a low bridge and it narrows down. And there's lots of boats moored up on the left hand side on the right hand bend, and I can't see anything coming, and that was something that the propeller's just caught under the water. Mind your head. There's a Kent and Haven boat there, look, tug services. Looks like this boat here's just had a paint job. Boat anymore, it's done up for living accommodation all down inside. Duke, British Waterways. Well, it's really narrow through here. Interesting little stretch of canal, very narrow, lots of moored boats. I wouldn't have wanted to meet anything there, but fortune and favours the brave, and nothing was coming. Squeeze through here too. There's a lot of boats that are not out on the canal though. There's loads of them moored up here. God's sake, we're into August now. You'd think the fleet would be out, but it's not. Well, I don't think I'd want to be a boat fleet owner in these times of high inflation, politicians' mismanagement. Must be a nightmare. Shardlow, 89 miles. Preston Brook, 3 miles. Well, he was in a hurry. Well, why did he bother to overtake the place? Differential here is literally a foot because it was two different canal companies and they didn't want the water from one to go to into go the other, so they put a lock there. So this is the levelling lock just before the Preston Tunnel. It was put there because the canal was owned by two different companies at the time, and the level on one was higher than the other, and they didn't want the water to go from one to the other, so they put this levelling lock in. The differential was only a few inches. Problem is the water's flowing over the gate literally over the gate, and it made it very, very difficult to open. Anyway, the Preston Tunnel, you're only allowed to enter it from the south end on the hour and for 10 minutes past the hour, that's all. Because there's only room in the tunnel for one boat, so it's one way. It's 1,272 yards long, and I don't like tunnels. I've decided I don't like tunnels. Anyway, we've got to do it, and that's all there is to it. So, we're about to go into the Preston Brook Tunnel in convoy. There's three boats in front of us. As much as I don't like tunnels, the engineering that went into it, considering it was done sort of 200 years ago, is just pretty amazing. There's a couple of houses sitting right above this tunnel entrance. See the light at the other end of this tunnel, so it's pretty straight. That's a vent there, look on the left hand side. Look. Is it a long way up? There's another shaft there to the right. Water coming through it. Well, there's very definitely light at the end of the tunnel now. So, out into daylight. So you need a Bridgewater Canal license for this section, but there's a reciprocal arrangement with the Canal and River Trust for 7 days if you've booked through, which I have. So we've got 7 days to get from the tunnel up to Manchester. I'm only going to poodle along anyway, I don't think it's that bad. Hiya. You see on the roof a long line of water, and that's where that ventilation shaft is dripping its tank all the way along the roof. The ducks are having a nap. Funny how they they do that all together. They all go to bed at the same time.
Yeah.
There's an old wharf building that's been turned over to residential. Looks nice actually. Busy motorway.
I suspect that's this bridge, and then you've got your part in.
Midland Chandler's right below the busy motorway. This must be the junction. One way takes you down towards the Manchester Ship Canal, I believe. The M56 we went under, and here comes a plastic boat steaming like a Grand Prix driver. Give him a ticket. Fishing, he's poised ready to strike by the looks of it. Yeah, there he goes. Caught something, but hello.
Hello.
Hey, child. first impressions of the Bridgewater Canal is it's in better nick than the Canal and River Trust canals. It's all neat and tidy. There's not many overhanging branches. The banks are all trimmed off. No wild growing weeds and foliage. I think they all need to bring the chief executive of the River and Canal Trust up here so he can just get an idea what he's not doing. This guy's steaming along too. She's having fun. Yeah, I think she's had a drink or two. Not so they can lift those beams of wood into the canal and cut off the water supply to one section. Moorfield Bridge. That's a dramatic sky. I just love the shapes of the clouds and the different colours.